didn't quite get that one. We're hearing the radio traffic. They are allowing deputies to continue making these attempts at the pit maneuver. Of course, maybe not right now where there's other traffic in the way, but that's definitely something that they may possibly try again. Yeah, definitely hard to get a look at the driver here. We haven't been able to get on the front end to really see what the driver looks like or know if it's a he or a she. So we're still not sure about that, but we do know that this driver is very erratic and very frustrated, running red lights. There goes another one right there. Looks like maybe LA County Sheriff's is getting back in this pursuit since we are heading westbound. I'm not sure exactly where the county line falls, but I would venture to say that we're back in LA County now, and LA County Sheriff's is picking the pursuit back up. You know, it could be a Nissan, maybe. Let me get a closer look here with our zoom lens on Sky 5, get on the other side of the trees here. Maybe a, you know, it's hard to tell on the monitor here. I know you guys have bigger monitors there. Maybe a Nissan Maxima, so definitely a sedan. Four doors, probably seat about five people in there. Not a sports car by any means, but, you know, anyone behind the vehicle of something like that could cause damage if they wanted to, which is the concern here, making a right turn, Diamond Bar Boulevard and Grand. So we're not going back to the scene of that second accident that this driver caused. We're going in the northbound direction here. You just saw one of the air units from LA County Sheriff's Department here. Continuing in this pursuit here, Diamond Bar and Clear Creek Canyon Road. We might actually be more in the Diamond Bar area to be specific now. Yeah, so we're definitely in the Diamond Bar area now, and this is definitely LA County Sheriff's continuing in this pursuit now. We're hearing them call out the shots now, going through another intersection there, but that may have been a green light. Let me widen out the picture here and just show you all the LA County Sheriff's deputies following this vehicle. This is not someone they want to let go, so sometimes we see them cancel pursuits when they get too dangerous, but this vehicle, this suspect has shown that he will do anything to get away and cause damage to get away, and he may have injured one of their own. So when that's the situation, that's definitely something where they will keep on this guy and make sure he doesn't get away, or at the very least follow him and make sure that they can keep the public safe with those sirens, with those lights, so people know there's a pursuit coming and they can get out of the way if they can.
Oh,
yeah, yeah. You don't know if he's... Oh, a couple cars impacted there, making contact with a bunch of cars. Looks like that might be an unmarked sheriff's vehicle joining the pursuit right now. So we just saw this suspect make contact with a bunch of innocent people there just to get away. So that tells you one thing, that this suspect is desperate, and maybe he's... Oh, very, very coming in hot on some traffic here. Impact with a bunch more cars. I think by my count, that's at least 10 cars involved in different collisions, and that might be it. We hope that's it. We hope there was enough damage to this car to maybe cause it to stop. We have Officers here getting in position, guns drawn. I'm going to widen out the picture here just in case anything really bad happens here. But there are a lot of innocent people in the way here. Deputies have to be very careful, including this car that maybe he doesn't know that this was part of a pursuit. He's just stopped there. He might think that this is just your everyday accident, but you would hope that he's looking out the window, seeing the guns drawn, and thinking maybe I better get out of here. You see LA County Sheriffs getting in close, again with their guns drawn. This is going to be South Diamond Bar Boulevard near Pomona in the Diamond Bar area, and we're going to see what this suspect decides to do here. There he goes. Yeah, I think one of the maybe this deputy here was kind of signaling to that driver to just get out of there, get to safety. You can collect insurance information later, but right now you need to get out of there and get to safety. Even these cars that are a little bit too close for comfort, sheriff's deputies are asking them to back up, and maybe they'll find another way to get these vehicles out of the area. But this suspect not complying, he might be hurt, he might be under the influence, we don't know. Since he's been there for a little bit, I'll kind of punch in and see if we can see anything. Looks like I can see it. Yeah. Yeah, groups at a time here. He's using a sedan to plow many cars out of the way. So you know that he's probably not going to be able to get this car moving again. But if he does know that, then he might be this might turn into a standoff situation where the suspect, we haven't seen him roll down his windows. We haven't seen him make any sort of contact by any means. I do see someone kind of moving around. I can't really tell if that's a reflection or if that's an arm. Yeah. And we hear the sheriff's deputy saying on the radio that they are aware that he is moving around, possibly searching for something. So that's a concern here. Again, he's not rolling down the window. He's not getting out of the car. His car door might be damaged to where it might not. It might be difficult to open. But you would think, maybe not. At this point, the sheriff's department just wants to get this suspect out of the car so they can keep everybody safe here. Right, and Yeah, I do see that. It looks like a pretty heavy coat. We're looking through the windshield now. And he is definitely shuffling around, moving his arm back and forth. Possibly, let's see. It looks like he's almost reaching in the back seat for something, or maybe in the passenger seat. And there you see his arm kind of reaching up, putting his hoodie on. Oh, and we just had some kind of round shot up there. I would imagine those are less than lethal, fired by the sheriff's department, possibly. Although, I can't really say that to be sure. But we did see when we were up close on that vehicle, the window on the driver's side was shattered. Unsure how that came to be, but we're going to try and find that out for you. Right before that, we saw the suspect put his hoodie on. So that leads me to believe that possibly sheriffs made the announcement that they're going to fire tear gas or something like that to maybe get this suspect more of a reason to get out of the car. So that would be my suspicion there. I'm going to be careful here going in close, just seeing if there's still any, see if the suspect's still kind of rummaging around there. Don't really see anything from this point, but LA County sheriffs are still going to make their calls just to be sure, because they want the suspect to get out of the car on their own terms. As I widen out the shot, you can see here this gas station nearby. There's a Carl's Jr. on the other side of the street. LA County Sheriff's also looking to get people kind of out of the vicinity, just to keep everybody safe here. Yeah, he's definitely not going anywhere. We still see him moving around in the car. I just saw maybe a bottle cap get thrown out, or that could have been the wind. Not really sure there, but we're just kind of keeping an eye on this suspect. And I keep seeing some activity there on the windshield, and I can't tell if that's leaves in the area or if deputies are actually firing less than lethal. Now that I see them walking away with one of those less than lethal devices, that might have been what we saw there. Again, that's to try and convince the suspect to have a reason to get out of the vehicle, maybe with tear gas or something of that nature. But he's still. Okay. Makes sense. Makes sense. Right. Yeah. That would really make sense. It wouldn't be much help. He would still be impacted by them, but definitely LA County Sheriff's using all the tools at their disposal to try and get the suspect to get out of the vehicle. And as we look at the car, there's a drone in the area too. I would venture to hope that is a drone launched by the county sheriffs. If a civilian is flying their drone around here, that is very dangerous, and that's definitely something that we don't want. But we have heard of, I'm not sure, LA County Sheriff specifically has begun deploying drones for situations like this, but there you have it, a drone flying over the suspect vehicle in what is now a standoff here in the Diamond Bar area. And there you go, another couple rounds there. Another couple rounds there being fired. very dangerous situation for sure. And this is, I think we're lucky to have this pursuit end the way it did without a more serious accident. I'm going to widen out the picture a little bit. Maybe we can see some of the cars that were involved in one of the very last accidents that kind of brought this pursuit to the end. And I don't see any emergency paramedics or anything like that tending to anyone in that area. So that's definitely good news. But the other good news is that those relatively minor crashes brought this pursuit to a stop. And now this suspect can't continue causing any harm to anybody else through the Diamond Bar area. And now this just becomes a standoff where LA County Sheriff's is going to use everything at their disposal to try and convince the suspect to get out of the car. We're hearing they're launching these non-lethal weapons into the vehicle once again to try and give the suspect a reason to get out of the car. Another note is that we did hear sheriff's deputies talking about the drone over this standoff scene as if they didn't put it there. So we're thinking now that that drone may have been a civilian in the area just trying to get a peek of the situation. That's definitely not something you should do. That it could just cause problems here with the investigation. And we do have an LA County Sheriff's deputy over the scene at a really low altitude, so that could also be a danger there. Yeah, and the next step here would probably be for the Sheriff's Department to get one of those armored vehicles out to the scene, or they're probably looking at different plans they have to get shields and get up close to the suspect to see if they can maybe coax him out of the car that way. But the best case scenario would be to probably get one of those armored vehicles here to the scene, get up close, and maybe from there pull the suspect out of the vehicle. But at this point, it's just a standoff. This suspect has given no indication that he wants to get out of the vehicle or that he wants to end this anytime soon. And these are the ones that might go for some time here. I'm going to try and keep a little bit of a wide shot here because I haven't seen a lot of movement anymore from the suspect. I don't know if he's, you know, he might be just tired and trying to hide from deputies at this point, but I'm not seeing any movement from him. So that would lead me to believe that deputies may be seeing that and they may want to maybe look at a couple other options here to get up close and see if they can look in the window and see what exactly is going on with this suspect. Yeah, you see some employees at the local restaurant here kind of checking things out, which, you know, it's fine if they kind of peek out and check things out, but you don't want to get close. I would venture to say that this person on the right side of the screen, and there's also a little bit of a bigger group here, people kind of shooting with their cell phones. That's a little bit too close for comfort, and I would maybe back up a little bit. But anytime this happens, you know, it's a it piques people's interest and they want to come out and check it out. And now with something like this, it's not something that is ending quickly. It's not something that sheriffs were able to get the suspect out and bring this to an end really quickly. This is now a standoff. So people are finding out about it on the news and on Twitter, and they're coming out to check it out, which we don't really want people to do. We want people to stay here and watch. You know, we have the best seat in the house to kind of see what happens here, so that's definitely the best option. Yeah, the information that we have is that this is still a Diamond Bar. This is on the south side of the 60 freeway as I widen out the shot here, and I will put our SkyMap 5 view on and add the maps to that so you can see the 60 freeway through that through your picture there, left to right, and then North Diamond Bar Boulevard north to south. That gives you kind of an idea of where we are in the San Gabriel Valley, and this is causing a little bit of a traffic situation here, not necessarily to the freeway, but definitely to Diamond Bar Boulevard. You're not going to be able to get on the freeway north or south from there. Yeah, there is now, yeah. Yeah, we're seeing. Yeah. Yeah, it's definitely hard to say what condition the suspect is in right now. We also don't know if he's under the influence of anything, really. I mean, the way he was driving, you can imagine that might be something that is part of what's going on here. But yeah, the window is looking very damaged, as you were just saying, and it's going to be a matter of time where he'll just be able to jump out the window. If his door, you know, we were talking about the door, it might be damaged to the point of not being able to open. But there are four other doors on this car that he could get out. But again, LA County Sheriff's taking no chances here. They don't know if this suspect is armed. I'm not sure if they were able to identify the suspect yet, since it was kind of a spur-of-the-moment pursuit, not something that they were following and then led to something else. It was multiple car accidents in the area that caused LA County Sheriff's to start this pursuit. So the information that they have to go off of as far as who this suspect is, what his history is, I'm definitely sure that they're working on it, but they may not have that information as of yet. So they have to take every precaution here, be very careful, and kind of stay out of the line of fire and stay as safe as they can be. Yeah, we see the suspect. It even looks like he still has his seatbelt on, so at least he was following that rule. And you know, he's moving around in the vehicle. He might be hurt. We don't know that for sure. But that's something that the Sheriff's Department is going to be taking into consideration here. But I'm betting the next step is going to try and bring in a armored vehicle or some other armored apparatus to try and get close and maybe talk to the suspect directly and convince him to give this up so you know, everyone can get on with their day. Right. We are hearing that sheriff's deputies are trying to clear off this sheriff's station. We were seeing, or sorry, the Chevron station. We were seeing a lot of looky-loos begin to gather here and maybe get a little too close for comfort, definitely more close than I would want to be to a situation like this. You see them putting up more yellow tape just to try and keep people away and keep people safe. A little bit of info regarding the two crashes that this suspect was involved in that kind of led to this pursuit. The first one, unknown if there were any, I don't know if anyone was hurt, was in front of the sheriff's station. That's the what led to the pursuit to start. And then it seems like a deputy that was involved in the pursuit got into a crash while they were pursuing this suspect, but the pursuit suspect himself was not actually involved in that crash. He was able to continue on while the sheriff's deputy was, their vehicle was disabled in the crash and they had to stop, but the other sheriff's deputies were able to pick this up and continue chasing the suspect. Here now to the intersection of Diamond Bar Boulevard, just south of the 60 freeway, where a standoff pretty much is continuing now as we go past 4:30 here this afternoon.
It's hard to tell. You can see his jacket there.
Just talking to my pilot here, David, we were wondering if he had moved to the back of the car. Can't really tell from here. He had that white jacket on, and I can still see that jacket there kind of in the over the center console. I'm trying not to go too close because, what if he got hit by one of the non-lethal rounds? As you guys were saying, it probably still hurts. But we're kind of wondering if he is moving around within the car or if he's still in that driver's seat, maybe just hiding under the jacket. And that's kind of the nature of the scene right now, this standoff situation, which, as Tim was saying, time is on the side of the law enforcement as they wait for other resources to most likely arrive and give them an opportunity to get up close and maybe talk directly to the suspect or maybe even pull him out if they can determine that it is safe to do so.
back. You might have been right.
We're definitely seeing a few more resources showing up here. A couple of the, looks like the Tahoes that LA County Sheriff's has, with deputies that were dressed up in more armor gear, definitely different, more so than from the other deputies that are just patrolling the street. So we're seeing a few of them show up, kind of gauge the situation. As Tim was mentioning, probably a scout person to determine what kind of resources they will actually need to bring over here to the scene. Another interesting thing we heard is that one of the deputies did say on the radio that they are seeing movement now in the back of the vehicle. So the suspect may actually be moving within the vehicle, and that's why we can't see anything through the front. So that's something that the deputies are going to want to keep you know, tabs on. But this is one of those static standoff situations where, as we've been mentioning, time is on the side of law enforcement as they get their additional resources here and try to bring this thing to an end.
Sorry, one more time, Booth. Okay, copy that. Sky 5, assignment desk, go ahead. Copy that, thank you. Good afternoon, everyone watching on the website, KTLA.com, and the KTLA 5 app, also KTLA Plus on your streaming devices. We're at the termination of this pursuit just north of the intersection of Palomino Drive and Diamond Bar Boulevard. LA County Sheriff's and Chino Hills Police involved in a very dangerous pursuit. If you've been watching us for the past hour and a half, we had coverage live on KTLA 5, lots of wrong way driving, multiple crashes with innocent drivers. There's the LA County Sheriff's Department helicopter going through the picture there. Very dangerous pursuit, and eventually came to an end right here at this intersection when the suspect got caught at a red light and eventually plowed through traffic that was keeping him at that red light, caused all this front damage that you see to this vehicle here, and eventually brought the vehicle to a stop. So we've been in standoff mode here for about the better part of the last hour. It is coming up on twilight here in the LA County area, so you're gonna see me adjust the camera as we get a little bit less light. The situation now that LA County Sheriff's Department is going to be trying to procedure that they're going to do here is they have officers from the Special Enforcement Bureau on scene. They are in these SUVs back here. I called them Tahoes on here. I apologize. They are more than likely Suburbans. And there you see another one, one of these black SUVs arriving on scene. And you'll see a very deputy in one of those vehicles, and they are covered in armor. They're dressed differently than the average street officer. And that's because they want to be more protected. They want to be, they're basically going to be the ones that are going to have to confront the suspect at this point, or at least that's what LA County Sheriff's wants to do at this point, is to have those deputies kind of take over the scene here. So one of those SUVs is now second in line here. The traffic that we're hearing over the radio is that they want to have some of these non-Special Enforcement Bureau officers kind of move more to crowd control and get people out of the area. We've had some looky-loos in the Chevron gas station on the left side of your screen, and also on the right side of your screen at the Carl's Jr. There's still a large crowd at the McDonald's and at the Shell gas station across the street there. But they want the non-Special Enforcement deputies to work on kind of keeping that crowd back and safe, and then the Special Enforcement Bureau deputies are going to come in close and hopefully bring an end to this standoff that we're going to continue watching here as long as we can. We have about, 10-15 minutes left on fuel here aboard Sky 5, so we'll stay kind of keeping an eye on this thing, and hopefully something changes in that time. But this is one of those situations where we are in standoff mode and time is on the side of LA County Sheriff's Department here as they try and wait the suspect out while they work on their plan to bring officers or deputies that are very well protected kind of into the area here to get in close and, if they have to, bring the suspect into custody by force. So we'll keep an eye on the situation high above Sky 5. For now, I'm Gabe Santos, live streaming on the KTLA app and KTLA.com. Oh, he's still moving. Thanks again for continuing to watch on the KTLA-5 app and on KTLA.com. We're continuing to monitor a standoff situation here in Diamond Bar, end of the pursuit. In the past couple minutes here, we're seeing kind of tensions kind of rise a bit here as the suspect, who had been pretty still, we weren't sure if he was in the back of the seat, if he was kind of hiding out in the car there. We're seeing him start moving around again, and we were zoomed in a little bit ago, kind of through the windshield. We could see that the suspect is basically reclined, if not kind of leaning over his center console into the back seat. Unsure why, unsure if he's hurt at all by the non-lethal rounds that LA County Sheriff's deputies were firing at the vehicle earlier. On the right, on the driver's side, window side, you can see that there's a lot of bullet holes there. And those aren't from bullets per se. Those are from the non-lethal rounds that deputies were firing to try and get a better view of the suspect. We're seeing some movement here. One of the non-special enforcement deputies kind of backing up from the scene. And if you were with our coverage earlier, we were with Tim Lynn, and he was kind of describing the process here and what the Sheriff's Department is going to try and do is kind of replace the non-special enforcement cars and deputies with these special enforcement deputies who have arrived on scene in high numbers. Well, you know, we have one, two, three, four, five, looks like five, six SUVs. Some of them are black, some of them are black and white, that are arriving on scene now. They have the tactical gear and the special equipment to get a better view of the suspect and also get up close to the suspect if they have to. We're going to keep watching the scene here as what I presume will happen is this car, number 29 on it, is going to try and back away from the scene because that's they just want to replace the non-special enforcement cars, there they go, with the special enforcement cars and get those up close to where they can kind of handle the standoff situation a bit more appropriately. You could see there's more of the SUVs on the top left of your screen and more on the top right of your screen. And now these deputies with bulletproof vests are kind of going to they basically want to take over the scene in the helmets and with their special gear. They want to be the ones to deal with the suspect if they have to, because they have more advanced tools to do so. So we will see that continuing to happen as we watch the scene here. More movement with a sheriff's car moving into the picture on the top left of your screen. No. I'm hearing some traffic on the, some radio traffic from sheriffs. I'm not going to say what it is, but I will say that they have a plan, and they are looking to possibly bring this to an end pretty shortly here, so we'll see if we can bring that to you live here. to all of our viewers watching on the streaming app, the KTLA 5 app and KTLA.com. We want to thank you for joining us here. If you were watching on television, this is the end of a very dangerous pursuit. This red vehicle at the bottom of your screen made contact with a lot of other innocent bystanders. And one of the crashes at the end of this pursuit basically took this vehicle out, caused enough damage to the front of it to force the suspect to stop. And thankfully so, because if you were watching our earlier coverage, you saw just how erratically this suspect was driving, just causing a danger to the public and himself. And as we go in a little closer here, you can see there's a little bit of movement still in the driver's seat. Looks like the suspect's kind of leaning into the back seat there, but officers are keeping a close eye on him. They are moving more resources into the immediate vicinity here. Just keeping tabs on the radio traffic here from LA County Sheriff's Department. They are working on a plan to possibly bring this to an end, hopefully shortly here, so we can bring that to you before we have to go for fuel. I should let you guys know that we have about 10 minutes left on fuel, plus or minus some. So we'll have to go when our pilot here says so for safety reasons. But we will keep an eye on it, and hopefully LA County Sheriff's Department will bring this to an end before we actually have to leave. We're getting a little bit of a wider view of the situation here. You can see if I switch to Sky Map 5, you'll be able to see Diamond Bar Boulevard there in the center of your screen, the 60 freeway left to right. Gentle Springs Lane and Diamond Bar Boulevard is the intersection nearest to where this pursuit came to an end and where the standoff is occurring right now. At the top of your screen there, you can see the air unit from LA County Sheriff's Department circling over the scene, trying to give deputies on the ground a better view of what's going on in that vehicle. I'll push in a little bit, and we're still monitoring the traffic, trying to get a better idea of what LA County Sheriff's Department is going to do here. And just as I say that, we're starting to see some movement. One of the Special Enforcement Bureau Suburbans moving in close. And this is their plan. It's to move the special enforcement vehicles in close and relieve the deputies who have been here for the better part of the past hour or so, just to get some fresh eyes in the mix here, so they can kind of take control of the situation. They have the equipment to better do that. They are more heavily protected with their helmets and their bulletproof vests. And you can see there this Sheriff Suburban getting their spotlights in position so they can have a better view of the suspect as nightfall approaches here in Diamond Bar. I'm trying to look around here. I was told that one of these vehicles is a canine vehicle. Don't quite see exactly which one that is, but we are told that there's a canine on site here. We'll see if they try to involve that at any point here. And of course, with any situation in the middle of a big city, you have crowds. And one of the things that the Sheriff's Department is trying to do, once those deputies are relieved from standby, Assignment desk, you may. I'm sorry, you're really low. I can't really make out what you're saying. Did you hear that? Yeah. If you can hear me on the microwave, it sounds like you're whispering. Let's see here. Assignment desk Sky 5 on Santiago, on the scrambler. I'm switching over to Santiago if you could hear me there on the scrambler. Or, there you are. I got you now. Go ahead. Go ahead, Sky 5. Go ahead, desk. You got me here. I just got the request to drop the map, if that's what it was. Assignment desk Sky 5, can you hear me better here? If you're still watching along with us on the KTLA-5 app and on KTLA.com, we're continuing to monitor this standoff situation here in Diamond Bar. LA County Sheriff's getting the resources in position here. This is the Special Enforcement Bureau resources. They're getting a team in place to hopefully bring this the situation to an end here, really. We've been monitoring the radio traffic with LA County Sheriff's Department, and they do have a plan in place. I'm not going to go into detail there for everyone's safety. Unfortunately, in situations like this, we will have to leave for fuel in a few minutes here. So if you see us drifting away, that's why. We've got to go refuel. We are limited in how long we could stay in the air, obviously. So we will go do that very shortly here, and if the standoff is still going on, we will come back to the scene and bring those pictures to you as they happen. Thanks again for watching us on KTLA.com with the KTLA5 app. I'm Gabe Santos, live over Diamond Bar. Getting close here. While we still can, we can still see the suspect moving around. Looks like he's wearing a white hoodie, and I can't tell if that's a shadow on the windshield or if it's actually kind of getting a little fog on the windshield there. We're hearing reports that the suspect may have been able to turn the vehicle on and is now revving the engine. We're going to keep an ear out on those reports and see what that develops into, but they seem to be pretty confident that he's not going to be able to get the car moving again. The engine might be running, but there's a lot wrong with that vehicle at this point, and even if he does get the vehicle moving in some respect, he's not going to be able to go very far. Also, LA County Sheriff's has such a contingent here of manpower that you can imagine they'll be on him pretty quickly, even if he does try to take off again, however unlikely that may be. Oh, really? Okay. Continuing to monitor this standoff situation in Diamond Bar, you see there at the center of your screen, LA County Sheriff's Department has launched a drone to get a better look at the suspect. You can see him at the bottom of your screen, still moving around there. But that drone is going to give deputies a much closer perspective than we can give you from here at a much lower altitude, just to kind of see whether he's armed, what is, you know, what he's doing, what he's possibly rummaging with there in the front of the vehicle. We are monitoring our fuel levels in Sky 5 here. We're going to have to go and refuel in a couple of minutes here, but we're trying to stay with you guys as long as we can as the situation kind of changes and develops, moving from daylight into nightfall. There you have the Sheriff's Department drone there at the center of your screen, relaying to deputies right now what the suspect is doing, basically what we're seeing, except closer and probably with a little bit more detail since they're cutting through the layers of air that we are shooting through, giving deputies a better idea of what the suspect is doing. We see a light just turned on there, not sure if that's from inside the vehicle or maybe the spotlight from the air unit. Getting a little wider picture here just to make sure there's nothing going on to the north of this standoff situation. At this point, as we've been saying, if you've been watching our broadcast on KTLA-5, time is on the side of law enforcement, even though we've seen the suspect stop moving, start moving around again, stop moving, and then now we see lots of movement coming from the driver's seat. That suspect you could see there in what looks like a white hoodie. And you can also see we're lined up perfectly with a drone right from the windshield. And look at that, the suspect taking one of those windshield covers, one of those sun covers, and it looks like a sun visor. I was searching for those words. Looks like he's going to put that up because he sees that drone, and he's looking at it, and he doesn't want the law enforcement to get a better view of him, so he's kind of lucky for his sake that he had that there. He's putting it up now. It could have been the spotlight that deputies also have that is probably bothering him, and that's why he had the sun visor up there. I'm being told by my pilot here that we do have to leave for fuel. I'm going to hold the shot as long as we can, but we're gonna make our way towards the airport here to refuel, and if this is still going on, we'll bring you pictures again when we get back to the scene. I'm Gabe Santos, live at Diamond Bar. Thank you for watching.